One-third of the world's population is unknowingly carrying something deadly within them. And that would be the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is an infectious bacterial disease. It is transmitted by means of droplets, just like the common cold. The pathogens usually attack the lungs. Initial symptoms are cough, night sweats, and fever. People with weak immune systems are the most susceptible to the disease. Worldwide, over 1 million people die from tuberculosis each year. Worse yet, the disease is becoming increasingly more unpredictable. Resistance to the antibiotics' effectiveness is on the rise, and we are running out of medication, especially in the area of so-called multi-drug-resistant tuberculosis, which is resistant to the two most powerful antibiotics that we have. We are definitely in need of faster, safer, more efficient therapies with fewer side effects in order to get this truly global affliction under control. There is, however, a glimmer of hope. For the first time in more than 40 years, a new drug has been approved. It is called Bedaquiline. Armed with their new active ingredient, these two men are out to get tuberculosis. The French chemist Jérôme Guimond and the Belgian microbiologist Koen Andries. For the two scientists, the research on a new tuberculosis drug is a matter of the heart.
Many people think that tuberculosis is a thing of the past and has been eradicated. But even today, every day, a couple of thousand patients die from tuberculosis. There is really a high medical need for new drugs against tuberculosis.
Developing and bringing a new drug to market can take decades and can eat up millions of euros. Without patent protection, few companies would be willing to accept the risks of such a massive investment. With a Belgian pharmaceutical company backing them up, however, the two researchers have started out in a favorable position. They have the necessary budget to make it through the long process, from the active agent to the approved drug, and a chemical library of more than 100,000 analyzed materials from which Jérôme Guimond can operate freely. At the beginning of our search, the challenge was huge. We just needed to find a starting point for our project to combat tuberculosis. Guimond and Andries test thousands of chemical substances, combine them, and then test them again. Many years and many trials later, the persistence of the duo is rewarded. They discover Bedaquiline.
Bedaquiline is a very special antibiotic in the sense that it is the first antibiotic ever described to interfere with the energy generation in bacteria. So it cuts off the energy, which makes them stop growing immediately. They sort of freeze, and after a couple of days, they die.
In time lapse, you can see how, after the addition of the agent, the microbacterium loses energy and slowly dies. And Andries has discovered another thing. The tuberculosis bacterium has a hard time forming resistance to the new drug because Bedaquiline is a so-called enantiomer.
Enantiomers are very special chemical compounds. They are like mirror images, like your left hand is the same as your right hand, but at the same time, they're not the same. They're the mirror image of each other. My right hand fits only in my right glove. My left hand fits only in my left glove. The bacteria has a very specific binding site, so only one of those enantiomers fits into there. The other one cannot fit into there. But the one that fits in there fits perfectly. And that's why an enantiomeric compound can be very efficient in inhibiting mycobacteria.
In 2013 came the breakthrough. The US Food and Drug Administration approved Bedaquiline. Production can begin. We have new drugs on our side in the fight against tuberculosis, a good first step that gives us hope, but by itself it is not enough. We need therapy regimen, that is several drugs that act together. We know how they work together and how to use them, so we still have quite a bit of work to do in this regard. For their efforts in the fight against this worldwide epidemic, the two researchers have now been nominated for the European Inventor Award. The Oscar of Technology is awarded every year to the great inventors of our time by the European Patent Office. This nomination is great recognition for all the work that we have invested into the search for medicines to fight against tuberculosis.
And it's also very important that a very important drug such as this one gets such an endorsement.
The two men whose discovery could be responsible for saving the lives of hundreds of thousands.